We will kick off today's highlights by going back in time to yesterday's swimming finals. They took place at the Taiwan Sport University Arena in New Taipei City. First up was the women's 50-meter freestyle final. Watch in lane 5 as USA's Caroline Baldwin takes a quick lead. Halfway through the race, it was still a tight one between Baldwin and Russia's Maria Kameneva. As she touches the wall, it's Baldwin that takes the gold medal with a time of 25.02 seconds. USA takes the gold, Russia the silver, and it's USA once again in the bronze. Baldwin only winning that one by 0.06 seconds over Kameneva. Next up is the men's 50-meter freestyle final. As they get off the blocks, watch in lane 5 as Ari Liukkanen takes a quick lead. He is the Finnish record holder of this event with a time of 21.93 seconds. He also competed in this event back in the 2012 Olympic Games. And when it comes to the end here, it's the Finnish athlete who comes out on top with a time of 22.02 seconds. He wins the gold medal in the men's 50-meter freestyle event. Behind him, it's Brazil's Amaral Duarte and Japan's Natsumi Nakamura who tie for second place with a time of 22.05. Next up is the women's 50-meter breaststroke final. It was a close one between USA's Andrea Cottrell and Australia's Leiston Pickett. In lane 4 and 5, they were neck and neck the entire race. As they approach, it's going to be who touches quicker, and it's going to come up for USA's Andrea Cottrell. She wins with a time of 30.77, only 0.05 seconds faster than the Aussie. And it's Ukraine's Maria Liver and Sweden's Jessica Eriksson that tie for third place. Watch just how close this race was. Again, 0.05 second difference. Next up, the women's 200-meter butterfly final. This one wouldn't be as close. With 4 lengths to go, it's USA's Ella Easton who comes out on top and wins this one by a huge margin of 3.11 seconds. After the first length, Easton nowhere in sight. It's led by Korea, Australia, and Sweden. But in the second, it's Easton who makes a huge push for it. At the 100-meter mark, she leads with a time of 1 minute, 1.31 seconds. Now, as she approaches the end, you can see Easton all alone. She ends with a time of 2 minutes and 8.21 seconds. Easton also picked up the silver in the 200-meter individual medley and the silver in the 4x200-meter freestyle relay. It was Sweden earning the silver and Turkey now earning the bronze. Next up was the men's 400-meter individual medley final. This race was dominated by Japan's Daya Seto. Seto won the gold in the 400-meter individual medley in the 2012, 14, and 16 World Short Course Champions. He also is the Asian record holder in the 200-meter butterfly and 400-meter individual medley. He is also the first Asian swimmer to be a world champion in the individual medley. Right from the gates, Seto led the way and it wouldn't stop now. You can see as he's approaching the end, has a chance to break the Universiad record, and he does with a time of 4 minutes, 11.98 seconds. He sets a new Universiad record, breaking the previous record of 4 minutes and 12 seconds. Daya Seto takes the gold medal, and behind him, it's athletes from Japan and Russia in second and third. Next up was the women's 400-meter freestyle final between Germany, Bahamas, USA, and Italy. Those four would come out on top, but it's Germany's Kohler that would finish in the number one spot, setting a Universiad record of her own. Nice. After the first 50-meter length, it's Kohler who takes the lead and doesn't let go of that lead. She will finish with a time of 4 minutes, 3.96 seconds, absolutely shattering the previous Universiade record of 4 minutes, 4.66 seconds. Kohler wins the gold medal. Behind her, it's Bahamas' Joanna Evans and USA's Sierra Schmidt. Love watching Kohler's reaction here as she sets that new record. She also won the silver in the 800-meter freestyle event and the silver in the 1500-meter freestyle event. This will be her first gold at a Universiade. Next, it was the women's 4x100-meter medley race. Eight countries, four athletes each qualified for this final event. And after the first length, it was Russia who led the way, followed closely behind by the USA. At the second length, though, it's Japan and Australia that pull ahead. Japan now doesn't give up that lead, and they finish with a time of 4 minutes, 0.24 seconds. And that's because every single one of these athletes have won medals in individual rounds, just this Universiade. Kanishi, she won the bronze in the 100-meter backstroke. It was Watanabe who won two golds in both the 100-meter breaststroke and 200-meter breaststroke. Hirayama won the bronze in the 50-meter butterfly, and the last and final leg of this one, Iragashi, she won the bronze in the 4x200-meter freestyle relay. So at the end of this, Japan takes the number one spot, and 0.25 seconds behind them, it was the United States of America that finished with a time of 4 minutes, 0.49 seconds. Italy took the bronze. Finally, it was time for the men's 4x100-meter medley relay. After the first length, it was USA in the lead after a dominating race by Justin Ress. Ress medaled in every single event he participated here in the Universiade, winning gold in the 100-meter backstroke, gold in the 4x100-meter freestyle event, and silver in the 50-meter backstroke. He would help USA propel now to the number one spot in this 4x100-meter medley relay. Second length was swam by USA's Andrew Wilson, and he handed it off next to Justin Lynch. Lynch continued the lead for USA, absolutely alone in this last one. He hands it off now to the final lap, swam by Ryan Held. In lane seven, Ryan Held gets going, can't reach that Universiade record, but does finish in that number one spot with a time of 3 minutes, 33.27 seconds. It's USA that takes the gold medal in the 4x100-meter medley relay. Russia comes in second, and it's Team Japan that finishes with the bronze medal. We'll stay with some of yesterday's athletics finals now over at Taipei Stadium. We're going to start with men's javelin, and this was one of the most exciting athletic finals that we've seen at this entire Universiade. First up, we will watch Taipei's hometown hero, Hyung Shi Fen. In his fourth throw, he puts his entire body into it. It lands at 86.64, and that sets a new Universiade record. What a throw. The Universiade record now set by the Taipei athlete, but it was Germany's Andreas Hoffmann who was up next. In his fourth throw, it reaches 86.64, and now he sets a new Universiade record. You can see everyone in this crowd freaking out a little bit, wanting that hometown record to be kept with Taipei, but Germany surpasses it. He's now in the second spot. But there was hope for the fans as they got ready to watch Taipei's Cheng Chao-Chen. as he lets it fly. He knows this one is good. It lands 91.36, and he sets the official new Universiad record. It was record breaker after record breaker here, but it's Cheng that comes out with the gold. Next up is the men's 400-meter hurdles final. No university records set here, but a few personal bests for each of the athletes. But at the end, it's Dominican Republic's Juander Santos Aquino who comes out on top with a time of 48.65 seconds. He also won this event back in the 2015 Gwangju Universiad. Santos in lane three. He's in the red shorts, the blue top. You can see as he approaches this final hurdle, he starts to pull away, kicking it into high gear. The defending champion of this event here at the Universiad comes across the final hurdle here. He wins this one with a time of 48.65 seconds. He beats Taipei's Chen Xie, who finishes with a time of 49.05 seconds. That's a personal best for him, and it's Algeria that comes in bronze. Next up, the women's 200-meter final takes to the starting positions. In lane six, it's Italy's Irina Siragusa. She takes the quick lead, speedy. She finishes with a personal best time of 22.96 seconds. Right behind her is Latvia's Gunta Latsiva. Latsiva also a personal best. She finishes with a time of 23.16, but it's Italy who takes the gold, Latvia who takes the silver, and teammate Italy's Anna Bongiorni who earns the bronze. Next, the men's 200-meter final. This one came down to the wire between France's Geoffrey John and Canada's James Lind. France's athlete in lane three, Canada's athlete in lane one. Watch just how close this is. It's a head nod forward that wins the gold medal for France's Geoffrey John. He finishes with a time of 20.93 seconds. Behind him, James Lind of Canada with a time of 20.96 seconds. And in third place, it's Slovakia's Jan Volko. Next up is the women's 100-meter hurdles final. After the qualifying rounds in the semifinals, it was the Dutch athlete Nadine Visser who was the favorite to win this one. All seven athletes on their starting marks. You can see Visser in lane five. Beside her is Belarus's Elvira Herman in lane six. And in lane seven is Luka Kozak of Hungary. Those three would come out on top in this race. But keep an eye on lane five. Visser absolutely dominates this race with no one around her. She finishes in a time of 12.98 seconds. A second place athlete not finishing until 13.17. Visser wins the gold, Herman the silver, and Kozak earns herself the bronze medal. Finally, it was time for the women's 3,000-meter steeplechase. 17 athletes from around the world qualified for this final. The Universiad record in this event was set back in 2015 at the Gwangju Summer Olympics with a time of 9 minutes 25.77 seconds. It was Turkey's Aslam Kaya that took the lead at the start of the race. You can see her in the front of the pack, followed closely behind by Turkish teammate Tugba Güvenk. Just over 4 minutes left to go. It's Kaya still leading the way and everyone else trailing and trickling behind. Approaching the finish line now, it's Güvenk who has stolen the lead, and with Aslam in second place, Hungary's Victoria Gyerkes pushes ahead to take that second spot. At the end, it's Güvenk who finishes in first, Gyerkes in second, and Aslam in third. With a time of 9 minutes, 51.27 seconds, it's Tugba Gouvenc who wins the gold medal. We'll head over now to the Taiwan University Sports Center, where it was the women's volleyball semifinal matchup between Taipei and Japan that got underway. With Taipei's victory over Argentina in the quarterfinals, they've qualified for this semifinal matchup, and it was Japan that beat Finland to bring them here as well. Now it was a spike by Masaki Yamuchi, kicked things off, dug up by Yang Menghyo. Taipei now back on the offensive, but the rally continues. Finally, it was Yuka Amamura who now tried for the tip, but things got underway and Wu Wahyu finally put it down. Then in the first, Taipei up by one. The rally would continue, but it almost a straight down spike by Xiang Wang Li puts Taipei up by 15. Now at set point, Japan tries to stay alive, but it was a strong spike that was a bit too strong, called out. Taipei goes up 1-0. Now in the second, it's back-to-back spikes for Taipei's Chen Xiaoya. Both of those prove unsuccessful. Great defense there by the Japanese. They keep it alive here. Goes for the tip. That one will be an easy one. They set up Chen one more time, and her third spike is blocked by the big Japanese defense now. Japan leads now 24-19 in the set point. If they win this point, they tie it up 1-1. But Taipei wasn't going to let it be easy for them. Great defense by Taipei. They go for the hit. This one blocked and no coverage for Team Taipei. Japan takes the second game. It's now 1-1. Japan takes the lead now in the third, and a back row spike by Li Xiangying gives Taipei the momentum. It's now 24-15. Japan leading the way at set point. Li's spike is out, and now Japan takes the lead 2-1 over Taipei. And in the fourth, Japan now up 13-9. They can't recover from Xiao's middle spike, and now they're right back in it. But Japan battles on, and at set point, it's 24-17. This would be one of the longest rallies of the entire game. Great defense there by Taipei, able to get it back. They go for a spike of their own. It looks like it's out, but she chases it down and is able to put it right back over the net. Taipei now back on the offensive. Another big block by the Japanese front court. Win the game now 3-1 over Team Taipei. Japan will move on to play Russia in the gold medal game on August 28th. Taipei will play the Ukraine for the bronze. Team Japan. Now for the table tennis women's and men's gold medal team matchups. This final is between Team Republic of Korea and Team Japan. The first matchup would take place between Korea's Jihee Jiang and Japan's Rika Suzuki. The first match here won 15-13, started it off for Team Korea, who won the first game 1-0. Then in the second, these two athletes went right back at it. This one wouldn't be as close though, and it was won by Team Korea 11-4. Korea up now 1-0. We move on to the second round of this gold medal match between Korea's Lee Hyun-hee and Japan's Miani Ando. Ando took the first and second games in this second round, 11-9 in the second one. And in this final one, 11-6, it's the Japanese athlete that takes it. And Japan now is tied with Korea 1-1. In this third matchup now, it was Korea's An Young-ing and Japan's Ayemi Naramoto. Naramoto won the first, and she was attempting her second here. She gets it over the Korean athlete. They would go at it one more time. This one now 10-2. It's Naramoto who goes the Absolutely beautiful cross-court hit. That one will take it now as Japan leads 2-1 over Team Republic of Korea. Now in match four, it's Korea's Jung Ji-hee back to the table, this time versus Japan's Miani Ando. The first game was won by Ando 17-15, but it was Jun who came back in the second and third to take them 11-1 and 12-10. Here's the fourth now. It's 10-8 right now. Watch as these two athletes go back and forth, but just off the table by Ando, it's Jun who takes the fourth. Now Korea is tied 2-2. In this final match, it's Korea's Lee Eun-hye taking on Japan's Rika Suzuki. At the end of this one, it is Team Republic of Korea that wins this team event 3-2 over Japan. And Japan's men's team got some gold medal action as well here at table tennis. They were taking on Team China in this final matchup. First up to the table was China's Zhu Linfeng and Japan's Masaki Yoshida. Japan led the way 10-8 to begin with, but it was Japan that battled back in the end. They took the lead 11-10, and in this final rally, it was Japan that won 12-10. But China battled back into it, winning the second game 12-10 and tying it right back up. China won the third game as well, and the fourth game you just watched, they won 11-8. China now taking a 1-0 lead. Watch the end of this fourth round. Beautiful play there by the Chinese athlete. Second round now is taking place between China's Kong Lingzheng and Japan's Yuya Oshima. Fast forward to the fourth game here. It's China leading the way 8-4. After it's tied up, they must go into a fifth game. China has the 10-7 lead, and a beautiful hit there brings them the 11-7 victory over China. They now lead the way 2-0. In this final round now, it's China's Lei Jiaxing versus Japan's Masataki Monozono. This one could decide it all. In the first two games, China took the victories, but Japan battled back here as Morizona took the lead 11-9 as Jiaxin hits it off the table to end this game three. But in game four, Jiaxin showed his dominance early in, taking the lead 9-6. It moves there to 10, you can see, and he scores one more after this to win the game 11-6 over Japan's Masataki Morizono. Team China wins 3-0 over Team Japan, and they earn the gold medal in the men's team table tennis competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiad. Finally, let's catch up on some basketball action from last night at Taipei Arena. It was a semifinal matchup between Japan and Russia. Russia took the first lead of the game with a nice inside look by Yulia Gladkova. Gladkova now on the baseline. The flare screen gets herself open in the middle of the key, puts it up, and it's good for Russia's first lead of the game, 2-0. But midway through the first, Japan led 11-8, and a jumper from beyond the arc by Saki Hayashi extended the lead by 6. Then just over a minute left to go, Japan steals the ball. Kato gets it up court, chucks it forward, giving to Saki the easy 2 to give Japan the double-digit lead now. 11 points in the second. It's a blocked shot that leads to a steal, and great transition offense gets Hayashi wide open under the hoop. Russia now calls a timeout as they trail by 13. They come out of a timeout, though, with a big three by Gladkova, but Japan, they go back down and answer that three ball with one of their own. Great ball movement here by Japan, and from the corner, it's good for 3 points. Now 24 seconds on the clock. Japan's Hayashi sinks the deep three to end the first half. She ended with a game-high 22 points, shooting 60% from beyond the arc. At the half, it's Japan leading the way 44-27 over Russia. Now midway through the third, Russia trailing by 21. They find a nice diving Chavoskova right in the middle for an easy two. Japan now let off another corner three. This team sunk 9 long bombs this game, shooting 39% from the three as a team. Now a 20-point lead. Russia looking to get it inside to their post player. Decide, though, to skip it to Chavoskova for the long two. That one is good to bring them within 20. On the other end, though, it's Shiori Yasuma who pulls up for the jumper. Japan now leads 68-53. Now a 20-point lead, the biggest lead of the game. Russia drills a three from the 45. A beautiful shot there by Lydia Patina. That would be her only bucket of the night. And in Japanese fashion, they go right back and they score a three ball of their own from the same spot. That 45 spot was hot for both teams. Now in the dying seconds, it's Patina who tries to get a couple more points on the scoreboard for Team Russia. Just won't fall. And at the end of this one, Japan takes it 84-63 over Team Russia. Japan will move on to the gold medal game where they will take on Team Australia. And it will be Russia taking on the home team of Taipei in the bronze medal matchup. Both these games will take place tomorrow night on August 28th.